So here you can see I've just got the carburetor soaking in kerosene. I didn't get the opportunity this week to go shopping and get some carburetor cleaner. I was just working too late, so I've just cut the top off a kerosene container, put the carburetor and the bowl in the kerosene. You can just slush it around to make sure all the carburetor's covered. Pop the top back on and they'll keep it from evaporating. I've got the choke cable on it. Yeah, so the choke cable's on at the moment. You can imagine if it wasn't there, that could sit right over the top and seal it well. So I'll let that soak for a couple of days. I'll take it to work and blow it out with compressed air and we'll see what we get. Okay, so it's the next weekend and during the week I got a comment from a Michael Adkins, M-I-C-H-A-E-L Adkins, A-D-K-I-N-S, and he says that I may have got myself a pair of bad spark plugs, or one bad spark plug at the front. As we know from the previous videos, the front cylinder only sparks when I let my finger off the starter button, and so he's got a good point. And what I'll be doing, I'll be following his comment. I'll be getting the rear cylinder spark plug, putting it in the front, and swapping them over, and just make sure that I still get the misfiring or non-sparking front cylinder. I've got this spark plug spark tester this time. This is fairly cheap. I think I only paid about $15-$20 for it delivered, and I'll be able to make sure now about the spark. Okay, we're going for a spark plug test on the front cylinder. I got these spark plugs new. These are new spark plugs. Now that's a good spark on the front cylinder now that I've swapped the spark plugs around. So I'll swap the spark plugs around again and see what I get. Okay, spark plugs swapped around. Okay, so a summary of the spark plug test is that there's good spark on the front and rear cylinder. So that turns it into a fuel problem. Now, I've had the carburetor removed, I took it to work, I cleaned it out with high pressure air, and now I'll reassemble it. Now, there's this very small rubber seal here, and just don't lose it. Very small little O-ring. So I've got my diaphragm, spring, and small O-ring. So just get them all located properly. It was all clean except when I blew the carburetor out just here where the choke mechanism is. Quite a lot of soot came out of there. It only goes in one way. Just get that that needle to sit in there properly. And she's bonza. This diaphragm tested good. There's a video on the diaphragm test if you look it up on my channel. Just goes into the spring and straight down there into that cup. Just make sure the diaphragm is sitting down in its groove there. So the jet that falls down into that cup there, not the jet, sorry, it's not a jet, it's not a needle, it's a bowl fuel level regulator. I can't think of the name of that right now. So you're putting the bowl back together, there's an arrow there, so you're going to go in the opposite direction to the arrow. It's loose on this side and binds on that side. Just feed it through. Make sure the bowl's level. I remember a fairly old video from Mr. Mac's story, how he got his bowl level. You can see that there's a ridge just along there. And you want that to line up with the edge of the carburetor there, and I'd say that that's fairly good. I don't know if that was in the video, but just there's a ridge along there. Could be a little bit too high. It seems to change. You can see there it's pretty level. Just want to check that float. So you can it can be a bit high, and then once you got that pin going, you can bend this down, push it down to get it level. There we go. Pins in. The float is accurate. And should be good to go. Always put any screws back in the thread and bottom them down just to make sure I don't lose anything. Got this rubber boot, and that will fit over that bit there on the bowl. and just thread the end in. Now the L that hooks into the back of this part here, and that comes off the accelerator, the throttle cable joins on there, and that activates this bit here. This just hooks up in behind there. There's a slot like so, and you know, you just put your bowl on. That brass bit there that goes through, just get that started there somehow, and just goes a little bit like that, and there we have it. And one thing I like to do is just run a bit of oil on the seal. I just feel like it brings me a bit of good luck, and sort of a good thing to do. Just want to keep it out of the bowl a bit. So there you go, that's your carburetor. It's as simple as that. It's a lot quicker and easier than replacing your fuel injectors on your car. No doubt a fuel injection system on a motorbike does the job. Okay, so it's the next day, Sunday. It's a really fantastic day today. We're heading into winter here. Winter's on its way, but today's terrific. So I was thinking yesterday how incredible it is that I've got the spark plug tester, and you know, spark plug, the front cylinder spark plug, rear cylinder spark plug are both 100%, and how that now turns this problem into a fuel issue. I got a piece of PVC. I was able to get a good bond to this inlet manifold, and you know, I blew as hard as I could, and there was absolutely no air passing through here at all. I'd know if there was a leak, and this is pure metal. There's some metal intake manifold, apart from the rubber gasket around the outside, and that signifies that the inlet manifold's good, the valves are good. So you know, this is a bit of a riddle, this one. Okay, so there's the main jet, and you can probably see through, able to see through those holes there in the jet, and see that they're unblocked. Yeah, sometimes I film things twice because not all of the movies work out when I come to edit it. Sometimes one of the movies is just missing or deleted, so that's why I be on the safe side sometimes and just make a second clip. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is test this inlet manifold pressure sensor, and what I'm going to do is just suck on the end of this tube here, and you'll hear it clicking, and from here it clicking mechanically, it seems like it works. The connection looks good. Most of the connectors are, they seem good on this bike. It's a fairly hard job to seal this properly. You can see a lot of bits and pieces pass through the body of this air filter. That's the inlet there, and this mates up to it, like so. Seems to work, but I don't know. It's a pretty hard ask. Okay, so it's time for the disclaimer. I'm not a mechanic. I've never worked as a mechanic. I can keep my car running and do maintenance on motorbikes, but I've got to admit that this has really stumped me, this problem. The foam does seem to grab, like maybe it works a bit better than I thought, or than I'm thinking it would, with all those holes in the foam and everything, but it all seems to bind together, and maybe it does form a good seal. Okay, so that's the fuel inlet hose there. I'm going to blow in just to demonstrate that the fuel will get through. Okay, so the inlet manifold pressure sensor working. I demonstrated that before. The connection's good. The throttle cable's connected, and the choke cable is routed through to the other side of the bike. So I've done this test before. We see that the petcock works. Okay, so what I've done now is I've flushed out the petrol tank, taken all the fuel out. There was little bits of rust, and but not too much. One thing I notice is the length of this fuel line here. The tank's more or less sitting in the position where it's got to be fitted. There's the petcock there, and you can see that it extends right out to here. Now what I'm going to do is just cut it and join it around about there. Okay, so I think that's better. That seems to look like it'll flow down into the carby better. Now I'll fill this tank up with fuel, and I'll just listen for it to flow into the bowl, and it should fire up the spark at the front and rear cylinder. The fuel system's perfect now, so it should go. Okay, so with a good amount of fuel in the tank, I'll turn on the fuel, and we should be able to hear it flow into the bowl. I didn't hear fuel go into the bowl, so I'm just going to just test it with the throttle, see if there's fuel coming out of this the starter jet here. Okay, obviously I haven't got enough fuel in the tank. Okay, a bit more fuel, I'll turn it on. No, I can't hear fuel. Nevertheless, there's fuel in the bowl. There we go. Alright, got a clean carburetor. Got it's all hooked up properly, everything's working. Full tank of gas. Brand new petrol. So, keep going and see what we get. Well, there you go. That's motorbikes. Perfect fuel system. Good spark at the front and rear cylinder. And that's the result. I've got one more trick up my sleeve, and that's to put the new ignition switch. This is from Easy Rider here in Australia. I think he's up in Queensland, so we'll see how it goes. I'd just like to say that there is a bit of an electrical smell when I fire it up like that. Stay tuned, and any comments whatsoever, any reasonable comments, I mean, very much welcome and appreciated.